Welcome to The Lead. I'm Jake Tapper. We begin with breaking news in the politics lead and a closing argument from President Trump, one that is inflammatory and divisive and based in fear, and that's according to Republicans. Quote, let's face it, we all know what's happening. That's what Republican Senator Bob Corker told the Tennessean newspaper about President Trump's midterm election focus on undocumented immigrants coming into the U.S. Corker adding, quote, it's all about revving up the base, using fear to stimulate people to come out at the polls. Now, we're 5 days out from the midterm elections. President Trump clearly feeling the pressure to keep Republican control of the House and Senate, and he's returning to familiar divisive territory. In minutes, the president is expected to speak from the White House about undocumented immigrants. We're going to bring that to you live. We're likely going to see then what we've been seeing escalate over the last few days and weeks. President Trump using the very kind of inflammatory rhetoric that he used to launch his presidential campaign back in 2015, demonizing undocumented immigrants.
They're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists, and some, I assume, are good people.
This time, this election, President Trump launched most recently an ad. It's pinned to the top of his Twitter account right now. It's an ad that even some conservative commentators have called racist. Republican Senator Jeff Flake said of the ad, quote, this is just a new low in campaigning. It's sickening. The ad features a Mexican man who was convicted in the killing of two California sheriff's deputies, contrasting the words and actions of that murderer, who has been sentenced to death, incidentally, with footage of the caravan of migrants who are currently attempting to reach the United States to seek asylum. The clear implication being that this caravan, these people fleeing their home countries, are all criminals and they're all seeking to commit horrific crimes. The president continuing to push this campaign of fear comes literally within days of that horrific murder at the Pittsburgh synagogue, where an anti-Semite slaughtered 11 Jews because he believed the right-wing propaganda he had been hearing, such as the lies that this caravan of migrants poses an existential threat to the United States and is being funded by Jews, such as George Soros. It's a claim, by the way, that the president continues to lend credence to.
I wouldn't be surprised. Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised. I wouldn't. I don't know who, but I wouldn't be surprised. A lot of people say yes.
A lot of people say yes, that Soros is behind the caravan. And while only the gunman is responsible for his actions, and we should point out, the gunman was not a fan of the president. He thought Trump was too controlled by Jews. The gunman was clearly motivated by this false propaganda, this idea that this caravan of migrants seeking asylum poses this existential crisis and this national security threat to the U.S., which it does not, according to national security experts. Now, is illegal immigration a problem that our leaders need to solve? Absolutely. But what it is not is an invasion. And those who have reported on the caravan from Central America, they say it consists overwhelmingly of people who are fleeing violence, not criminals seeking to inflict it here in the U.S., which is clearly the picture that the president paints.
They got a lot of rough people in those caravans. They are not angels.
They can't invade our country. You look at that, it almost looks like an invasion. It really does look like an invasion.
That's called an invasion of our country.
It's not called an invasion of our country. It is remarkable that with bodies still being buried in Pittsburgh because of this bigotry, this propaganda, and these lies, that the president and his campaign would take actions not to heal the nation, not to bridge divisions, but to fuel the fire.